coaster is all about energy. You go very, very slow up the ramp, and you gain a lot of height, i.e. a lot of potential energy. And when you get to the top, it starts rolling down, and as you go lower and lower, faster and faster. Kinetic energy, which is related to how fast you go. There is an awful lot of engineering that goes into creating the tracks and the paths that you actually run. So I was looking at this roller coaster here, and there are about four different places where they're basically gaining speed and losing height. And there are two forces at play, one pushing straight down, which is called gravity, and one pushing to the side, which has to do with the turning. And so they bank the turn such that when you add those two forces, it goes straight through your seat and you don't get pushed out of the car in either way. The same reason they bank turns on highways. So there are a lot of other rides here at the fair, and they all have the same basic principle. In that ride, when the ride is going slow, like it is right now, basically the cars are hanging straight down because the only force on the cars are gravity pushing them down. As the ride speeds up, the cars get sort of thrown outwards, and you can figure out by how far they're getting thrown outwards how much force must be pushing people outwards versus down, which is gravity. And so as engineers, those are the kind of calculations we would do. A lot of these rides are really playing with your sense of equilibrium, playing with the force, the fluids in your inner ear. A lot of these rides don't have very high forces, but they change things so rapidly that it really confuses your ears to make you think something else is going on. I do think about the forces. I think about how the designer actually created this thing to give the people the maximum thrill.